Yeah, hi, everybody. So, page down. It's sort of messed up. But luckily, only one slide. So here I just wanted to explain why we are interested in the subject of my presentation. So we have two projects using semantic web technologies, one more focused with respect to the domain, the self-psychoontology, and with respect to the biological taxa, included only four, and the other one very broad, totally domain and taxa in specific.
Could you speak more into the microphone, please?
I'll try. Is it better now?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. What we have now in the fields of semantic web in biomedical domain. So we have witnessed a successful development of quite a number of triple stores, or let's say semantic knowledge bases, but they are all essentially warehouses with all the consequences of that. And the problem with that is that actually warehousing goes totally against the core, the essence of the semantic web vision, the semantic web as a web of data where different sources are seamlessly integrated and could be queried without warehousing. Yeah? So it means that without federated queries, the idea of the semantic web will never take place. And therefore, we try to evaluate to what extent the developed triple stores in biological or biomedical domain are suited for, say, federated querying. Yeah, so a little bit more about sharing. So I finished stressing the importance of federated querying and our intention to try to evaluate to what extent the available resources supported. We selected these four triple stores, varying strongly in their size. We used this simple query, which returns the local environment of one particular constant. In this case, this is the protein CDC2, which is present in all the four triple stores. This query dutifully returned the expected local environment from all the four stores. But the problem with this output that it looks ugly. It is full of URIs, and the URIs, it's the least thing biologists want to see. So we try to make it more human readable. So we use the series of queries. This is a typical query in which we used the predicate RDFS label, but in reality we use all the four this type of predicates recommended by linked data. RDFS label, fourth name, scores pref label, DC terms title. So only RDFS label returned human readable results, and only for two resources. The other three didn't return anything. Additionally, we noticed that the resources varied with respect to the use of the predicate RDFS-C also. So, all in all, it clearly indicated that the use of predicates varies a lot between among these four triple stores. It means that right now we are not ready for a federated querying, because what you actually need for a federated querying, you need to submit query one to triple store one, query two to triple store two, and then a query three over the union of the triples retrieved by the first two queries. Yeah? So if the set is empty for one of the two first queries, then you don't have any federated query. This is what I just summarized, and this led us to conclusion that there is some need for additional efforts to harmonize the way the data is modeled in biomedical triple stores, including the use of predicates. Our proposal is to create an RDF foundry with a mission very much like the mission of the OBA foundry, but in this case with regard to triple stores. By far the major task of the foundry should be to identify a minimal set of constraints on the way RDF should be and could be used in the triple stores included in the RDF foundry. This could be done in first approximation in two steps. The first step, all the linked data principles and recommendation should be accepted, all of them, accepted and used. Cool URI should be used, user-friendly predicates of the type RDFS label and the other three should be systematically used. Reification shouldn't be used, blank nodes shouldn't be used, and so forth. So the advantage of this approach is that it doesn't need a development of a new software which would be used by all the developers of the triple stores, because all of the developers already have their own software which has been used successfully and always needed just to tweak a little bit make the output consistent with the requirements of the RDF foundry. In the second step, the set of the constraints could be and should be refined. There are many different options, of course, and these would be the major task of the RDF Foundry. And right now we could propose already an additional constraint that the predicate RDFS C also should not be used at all because it is devoid of any semantics and it goes completely against the idea, the concept of the semantic web. Yeah. So, it should be a collaborative effort, yeah, and input from everybody interested in creating a family of biomedical table stores, which could be used efficiently for federated querying, could be developed. So, please, if you have any ideas in this respect, please be proactive and let us know. So, and that's actually at the end of my presentation.